Hello and welcome to another Magic the Gathering unboxing. So in a previous video I unboxed the other Planeswalker deck, that was the Ajani deck. I did a bit of a preamble which sort of, you know, helped people get their head around the concept of the Planeswalker deck and talked a little bit about it historically. So if you're interested in you know, that discussion, I won't be repeating it here, so you can watch the you know, go back through and have a look at the Ajani video for the Planeswalker decks if you haven't already done that. Before we get out onto the actual unboxing, which I know that's what most people are here to see, again a little preamble. This time round, slightly different approach. Not really talking about the theme of the Planeswalker decks, but talking about something else that did cross my mind when I was doing the original video. Didn't really have much time to explore. And also, thankfully, one of the friends of the channel in the comments section reminded me that I needed to do this. And that's the thing that I think leaps out at you, or certainly looked out at me and the friend of the channel, was that when you go through this deck, you start thinking that these cards look really interesting in Commander. And I think it goes back to something I mentioned in the first video about overlapping themes in decks, you know, where you have this thing where often there'll be a cares about theme, and in also in the deck there'll be this theme that's relevant to the set in respects of a certain mechanism. Ability, call it what you will, and there's this overlap, and in that overlap there may or may not be varying degrees of synergy. Now in the Ajani deck, the impression I've been given, and this is from an article I read on what's it called now, The Gatherer, I think. No, not The Gatherer, Gathering Magic, that's Gathering Magic. They were commenting that they felt that where that overlap occurred, the synergies were more, there was more synergy in the Tezzeret deck for that overlap. So when we open this deck, we'll see what the actual overlap is. But again, because of that, this is probably more appropriately going to be the video where I witter on about commanderizing product, which I know has been mentioned before. So this is where you basically would take a sealed product and you'll strip out the chaff and then start to rebuild it to a 100 card singleton format with an appropriate legendary creature as the commander if it doesn't already feature one in the deck. So how might you go about that? So very quickly, and this is I think probably more deserving of a series. There's two broad approaches that you can take, and within that there's lots of little other things you can do, but generally two broad approaches. You can take almost like a surgical strike approach where you basically just, you know, remove all the chaff, you look at all the key cards that you have which you think are going to synergize, and then you start feeding those cards through a site like EDH Rec to get recommendations about other decks that feature those cards, and then you use that to build an incredibly synergistic deck. The other approach is to take a more organic approach, and working from the deck, obviously again taking out any chaff, start looking in the immediate environment. So you start going, well, what's in Aether Revolt, then going out to the next level, which would be what's in the block. You know, maybe is there anything in Standard that currently synergizes well with these, and then going further and going, well, you know, obviously at some point you've got to think about a commander if there isn't already one in there that's, you know, commander ready. So, you know, what blue black commanders that care about the particular theme, you know, maybe here care about artifacts, are there available? If I go back far enough, maybe I've just got, there's an on color general. And I'm talking about, you know, going right back to Legends, the set Legends, where there was a lot of fairly plain two-colour generals, but maybe picking one that has high power, so you can do the old three strikes and you're out trick, like you find in the original Elder Dragon format where you're using Elder Dragons, which will have 7 power, and so 3 hit good hits with those, and you've killed someone with 21 commander damage. So yeah, that's another avenue if you can't find anything that synergizes well. The other possibility is to add in a third color. You can add in this case, white. So that's going to push you into, I think it's Esper, and looking at just commander product that's already available, you'll see that there's like heavy artifact presence in there. So again, that's another thing. You can like look at available commander product. Have they released anything on those colors? Is there anything in those decks that are going to lend themselves well, because they're going to be there in for a reason? Another good thing is if you can dig out the original Benny Smith articles, I think they were on Star City Games, where he goes through these two color sort of, I suppose it when you would call it Commander Starter packs, where it was like a suggestion of about, I think, 20 cards in each of the two colors, and also what he called a universal package. And you would sort of combine the two and then just basically put in cards that you wanted to play. So it's real sort of old school EDH approach, where it's more about, oh, I've got this really cool rare, I want to put it in my deck. But there's loads of useful utility cards in there that just, are useful in a commander deck, because they fulfill certain things that you're just going to be need to be dealing with all the time. So there's lists like that. I suppose people call them what, like auto include lists. I mean, a lot of people in Commander don't always like using that term. Or staples is another one. So those sort of lists, I think they're useful where you're maybe missing a few cards and you just want to put something in there that's a universal, deals with a universal problem. So one way you can look at the immediate environment is to dig out your player's guide. Start looking through, are there any lords that are on color? Are there any artifact lords? If we're talking about artifact synergies, what's in blue, what's in black, that might be complement the deck that isn't already in here. Then we go back to the block, we look at Kaladesh. Already, maybe there's some interesting stuff starting to leap out at you. We do have in Kaladesh, I believe, what you could call an artifact lord. We have Chief of the Foundry. I don't know how clear that is. So that cares about artifact creatures, gives them +1/+1. There was another card in here which also I think was of relevance, and I'm trying to remember where it is. Oh, there's Foundry Inspector, which if you're playing really heavy artifacts, artifact spells you cast cost one less to cast. And there's other, obviously cards in Magic's history that have done that sort of thing. There was also an interesting, there's a few things that are designed in the set as artifact pointers. And these are the two color cards, draft pointers, and you've got things like Contraband Kingpin. Whenever an artifact enters the battlefield under your control, scry one. So those are the sort of things I'm talking about. And again, as you go back in Magic, you might find more powerful versions of those cards, but it gives you some clue as to what you might be looking for. You could also, look back at previous commander products. So we recently had the four color commanders. The one I'm thinking about is Breyer, and I believe in that, I'm just digging out the deck here, we had Silas Wren. So that was one of the partner commanders, but we can just play this on its own if we wanted to. And this is a single white, a single. So single generic mana, a blue black for a 2/2 with death touch. Whenever Silas Wren, Seeker Adept, deals combat damage to a player, choose target artifact card in your graveyard. You may cast that card this turn. So this does care about artifacts, but it would involve you going down a particular route in terms of now you need to think about, well, this is all about getting artifacts into a graveyard. Well, that's not difficult because you're in blue and blue cares about mills. So again, that could be an avenue you could go down. So, you know, just basically very, very quickly going through the commanderization of a product like this. You know, like I said, it's basically looking at inspiration for the synergies that you are going to find in the deck. So let's open this deck up and check out what sort of cards we've got in here. Open up the boosters, see what stuff we pull that might be on colour, but also, like, again, looking out for this sort of secondary theme of this particular video, which is, you know, how might this this deck work if we strip out all the chaff and start commanderizing it. So you saw the contents in the previous video of Ajani. So there's our deck with Tezzeret. We've got our two packs from Aether Revolt. We have our Aether Revolt. This is actually the deck description, which tells us how to play the deck. And how to, I've noticed with this improving the deck now, they've been very broad. Like with previous theme decks and intro decks, they always used to suggest particular cards, but now they're just talking very, very generally about this. So there's a bit about how to play and a bit about Tezzeret, and there's our usual quick reference guide, sort of replaces the old how to play. So we have a nice shiny Tezzeret Master of Metal. Let's just open up the rest of the deck so we can go through this. Tezzeret Master of Metal. 4 a blue black Planeswalker Tezzeret. 5 Lorti. So the +1 is reveal cards from the top of your library until you reveal an artifact card. Put that card into your hand and the rest on the bottom of your library in a random order. -3, target opponent loses life equal to the number of artifacts you control. And -8, gain control of all artifacts and creatures target opponent controls. So we have Merchant Dock Hand in here. So what I'll do again with the deck is I'll specifically go through the rares individually, and also any other card that sort of jumps out at us. So, one generic artifact creature construct. It's a 1/2, 3 in a blue, tap X untapped artifact so you control. Look at the top X cards of your library, put one of them into your hand and the rest on the bottom of your library in any order. Quicksmith Spy, another rare in the set, in the deck. 3 and a blue, 2/3 creature human artificer. When Quicksmith Spy enters the battlefield, target artifact you control gains tap, draw a card for as long as you control Quicksmith Spy. Tezzeret's Betrayal, 3 blue black sorcery. Destroy target creature. You may search your library and or graveyard for a card named Tezzeret Master of Metal. Reveal it and put it into your hand. If you search your library this way, shuffle it. As I mentioned in the Ajani video, remember with these decks, there's a number of cards which are specifically only available in the deck. So those are other cards you want to watch out for. They're listed actually at the end of the player's guide. And there's a couple of those in here. Ornithopter, 0/0/2 with flying. Augmented Automaton, and there's a couple of those. Dund Operative, Tezzeret Simulcrum, and you can see that cares about Tezzeret as well. Dakara Peafowl. Treasure Keepers in here. Foundry Assembler has Improvise on it. So we're probably going to see some Improvise in this making this particular deck. It's obviously synergizes well with the artifact theme in here. So if we just look one of these, it just says improvise. Your artifacts can help you help cast this spell. Each artifact you tap after you're done activating mana abilities pays for one. Bastion Inventor. Windkin Raiders, another card with improvise on it. And there's a couple of those. Ironclad Revolutionary. Barricade Breaker, another card with improvise on it. Fen Hauler. Universal Solvent. Pendulum of Patterns. And we have four of those in here. So just because it's always useful to flag up the card where they seem to be having a lot in here. So it's two generic mana artifact. When Pendulum of Patterns enters the battlefield, you gain three life. Five mana of any colour, tap, sacrifice Pendulum of Patterns, draw a card. Implement of Examination is in here. It's also got card draw on it. Essence Extraction. Tezzeret's Touch. Reverse Engineer, another improvised card. And now we're moving on to the non-basic lands. So I think there's, again, as there was in the Ajani deck, there's a full set of on-colour, you know, mana-fixing land here. Admittedly, these are tap lands, and these tap for blue or black and come into play tapped. And there's four of those. And then we just have the basic land mana base here, and you can see this, I've mentioned this multiple times, but I just love this like swirly artwork that they have on these, particularly the islands. So we've got our blue and our black mana base. So there we have the deck. And you can see, you know, a lot of artifact related stuff, in particularly in relation to improvise in here. I think really for a multiplayer format, if you were thinking about commanderizing this product, and, you know, like I said, that sort of thing would be for a separate video. I'm not going to go into a massive amount of depth. I've explained the overall concept. But I think you would find a lot of this stuff would come out, that you would have to find something that was a bit more multiplayer friendly. But you've got the whole of, you know, Magic's history to pull from. You know, at the very least, what the deck's going to do is like inspire you to go down a certain route there. Okay, let's open up these, see what we've got. Fresh cards, nothing like it, eh? Okay. So, Aether Chaser. So, doing our commons first. Shipwrecked Moray. So, that K is about energy. Caught in the Brights. Daring Demolition. Natural Obsolescence. Fen Hauler. So there's another, we've got Fenor in the deck already. Implement of Improvement. Welder Automaton. Aetherstream Leopard. Iron Tread Crusher. That's vehicles. Trophy Mage, so moving on to our uncommons. Ridge Scale Tusker. Hidden Stockpile. Oh, cool. So we've got a not necessarily relevant to our deck, but it's always nice to get a legendary creature. Shram Senior Edificer, one and a white legendary creature advisor, a dwarf advisor. Whenever you cast an aura, equipment, or vehicle spell, draw a card. So that would be an interesting card as a mono white commander to have a play around with it. We've got a mountain and a Thopter. So, I mean, to me, not much of just looking. We got Trophy Mage, which helps tutor for artifacts with converted mana cost 3. It's pretty specific. The trouble is some of the artifacts here require other activation costs. We've got a Fen Hauler, which is already in the deck, which has Improvise on it. And we have removal for creatures or vehicles in there. So, yeah. I'm probably, in that one, I was more interested in the legendary creature, which was, has nothing to do with the deck. But, Frontline Rebel, Dispersal Technician, Audacious Infiltrator, High Spar Infusion, Cruel Finality, Unbridled Growth, Implement of Ferocity, Reservoir Walker. It's an artifact, but it cares more about life and energy. Implement of Malice. So this does have a black activation cost on it. Although more about discard. Filigree Crawler. Helps you create Thopters. Ironclad Revolutionary. So we're moving on to our uncommons. Morphist Revolutionary. And Thopter Arrest. And our rare is Peacewalker Colossus. So 3 colourless, 6/6. One and a white activation cost on it. It's an artifact vehicle. And for the one and a white, another target vehicle you control becomes an artifact creature until end of turn. It has crew 4 on it. A planes and a servo token. So again, you know, we've got cards that clearly care about artifacts here. Whether or not anything of any consequence would replace anything in the deck is another matter. And there's a removal there for 2 toughness or less creatures with Scry on it. We've got Artifact Bounce. I always find things, cards like this, where they bounce things are very interesting for re-triggering ETBs. So this is when Dispersal Technician enters the battlefield, you may return target artifact to its owner's hand. So if that artifact happens to have an enter the battlefield ability on it, you could re-trigger that. But whether or not it's worth having a card like this in the deck just for that is another matter. But again, just things to think about when you're sort of looking at cards. Sometimes the utility doesn't always sort of leap out at you, and it's just a question of sort of sitting there and saying, well, does this particular card do anything that I've not really thought about in terms of consequences? So there we have it. That's the Tezzeret deck. I think they actually did call it. Yeah, Tezzeret Master of Metal. So it's actually a named after the Planeswalker. And that's it. Again, another deck box that actually doesn't look like it will fit sleeve cards. So a bonus. There you have it. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.